Hello guys, welcome to Malik034 channel. This is Malik Arjun. In today's session, I'm going to explain what is client connectivity, how client connectivity is going to happen in real application cluster, and what is TAPA, transparent application failover, and FAN, what is FAN, like fast application notification. All these three are interconnected and correlated each other, how all internally mechanism works, and I'm going to explain with a live demo and demonstration. If you see, the today is the day 7 in my RAC internal real application cluster. I already covered a couple of topics and uploaded to my YouTube channel. If somebody missed those sessions, I request them to go back to my YouTube channel and refer them for the ease of understanding future series. If you are new to my channel, I request you to go back to YouTube and search for Malik034 and please do subscribe. If you like my videos, please share, like and comment. Starting with the today's session. When client connectivity comes, you should understand two terms, connection and the runtime. Connection is the initial phase where until the client connection is established to your database, and runtime, when the connection is established, whatever the query, whatever the your session do, how to manage them. That is connection time and runtime. Connection time, there might be a load balancing and failover. And runtime, there might be a load balancing and failover. These are the four terms you should remember. I will explain you what are these in brief. In the connection time, right? Connection time, load balancing, I say scan is always going to span three IPs, 100, 200, 300. It will be in a round robin. First three connection, it will 100, 100, 200, 300. And fourth connection, again it will 100, it will assign 100. And fifth connection comes, again it will assign 200. And sixth connection comes, it will assign 600. Like, in a round robin, it will be a load will be balanced across all these three IPs. And how the connection failover happens? If the 100 is not available, it will go to 200. If 200 is not available, it will go to 300. And the connection time, it will be balances the load. This is client connection load balancing and the client connection failover. Like, 100 is not available, it go to 200. If 200 is not available, it will go to 300. Like the connection time itself, the failover is going to happen in the if you are using the real application cluster. And how runtime is going to happen? For example, if 100 is not available, 200 is not available, and 300 is assigned to one of the client connection and it connected to node 3, and then this is become runtime. Now the connection is established and this client can do any operation. And then any queries, any load you can do. And then how the load time failover is going to happen? If this node goes down, and then your scan is going to shift to any one of the surviving node, like node 2 or node 3. It is going to connect to node 3 and node 4. Likewise, connection failover happens. This connection failover happens because your scan will be running in VIP. VIP is like virtual IP. But the moment this node goes down, the VIP will be floating in your cluster, and then after a certain time out, it will shift to any of the surviving node. If you see here, like failover mode, select and method basic and retries 180 and delay 5. With this configuration, it will wait for, it will retry for 180 seconds and 5 second delay, and then type is select. If you have not used a scan or VIP, then this connection failover mechanism will not be possible, right? So this is kind of a connection failover, and the question comes here: what kind of connection failover? Whether select queries will failover, or DML queries failover, or DDL queries failover? What kind of queries failover? That I'm going to answer in next slide, and next couple of slides, I hope. Okay, and then what are the more information? If you need more information on this client connectivity, how this connection time failover and runtime failover and connection time load balancing and runtime load balancing, how it is going to happen? It is going to happen with help of scan and your local listener, already covered in my previous sessions also. If you need more information, and please do refer this particular mock document for troubleshooting and how to fix the issues. And there's advanced configuration feature with this MOS document. You can configure. Going to the next slide. Once the client connectivity, if we talk, there will be always two terms will be in your mind. One is the TFA and one is the FAN. What is TFA and what is FAN? TFA is the transparent application failover, and FAN is fast application notification. TFA, right? If you enable TFA in your rack, it tries to make client unaware of the failure. For example, if this connection is initially established to the node 1 and node 1 went down and automatically shifted to node 2, and this is client will not be aware my node my connection has failed over to any of the other node, because it is transparent to the end user or transparent to the application, right? This connection failure happens due to CTCF, connection time connection failure and runtime connection failure. This is the failure. As I asked you question, what kind of queries, what kind of sessions are going to fail over? Only pure select queries. If it's running select queries, and that select query will be failed over, and then that select query will be keep continuing executing on this node. And what happens if you do any delete, truncate or DML, DDL operation? That is a question I will answer you at the end. See here, I already written here, write transactions need to be reissued. If any DML operation, once the connection established to this node, that query need to be resubmitted. The application need to be TFA aware. The TFA aware, transport application failover, TFA, that application need to be aware. That application aware, it comes in the fan. Fan, right? Fast application notification, what happened? For example, this node goes down, the fan notification will be sent out. Fan notification, for example, it will say if my cluster resource up or down, or it is using UDP or TCP, all these notification or events it going to share with all other cluster nodes and all other your application. If your application is configured with TFA should be configured at application level also, right? So once you configure at the database level, that your application should be aware of TFA has been configured in your database. So that, whenever the notification happened, fan happened, like event happened, for example, this node goes down, automatically that information is sent across all the cluster nodes, all the scans and all your application. Why it will send out those notification? Because whenever application try to connect via scan will not try to connect to your failed nodes. It will always try to connect to any only surviving nodes. That is why, fan will play an important role to avoid these kind of misconnections. For example, fan wants to inform clients, fan, like moment this node goes down, the event will be created and then that will be triggered and that will be sent to all the cluster node, all the application and all the scan resource, so that this node is down, so don't ever try to connect to that node until next notification. And once this node is up again, the fan notification will up notification will be sent to all the cluster resource and application, so that this node is up, now you can try to connect. Fan will helps avoiding these kind of delay in connections and avoiding these unnecessary events. Okay, so I already covered what is HA and what is load balancing. My previous session also covered, and few minutes back also I covered. HA is like high availability. As I said, scan will be spanning 3 IPs, 100, 200, 300, and whenever the client tried to connect, it will try to connect to 100. It is not there, it will go to 200. It will go, if it is 200 is not available, it will go to 300. Like that, load balancing, high availability, like three ways of high availability is going to happen in the scan. And load balancing, scan is smart enough to find out which is the least loaded connection and try to connect to that that node, so that load balancing will be achieved. That will be available. That will be achieved only using scan. So how this fan and fan, right, fast application notification and TFA, transport application notification, can be achieved by defining services. I already covered in my previous session how to define services and how to deal with the services. I'm going to create one more time. I already opened two node rack here, rack 1 and rack 2. The command is sservicetl add service dev db. My service is the service name, dev db instance 1 instance 2 and hyphen p basics. I'm going to create a service. Okay, my service already exists, fine. So it's already created in my previous session. So I will do configuration. I'll check configuration of that. My database name is DevDB. Okay, see here, application failover type, application failure method, TFA failure type, and TFA failure delay. So if you set all these parameters, so your application knows, and if you try to connect your application via using this my service, so automatically your application will be aware that which node is up, which node is down, and which node is having least connection and which node having more connection using this FAN, fast application notification failure. Right. Okay, this FAN is aware. FAN is aware of the connection full. What do you mean by connection full? Whatever the connection from the client side or application side or whatever the end user connection happens, it is going to be pooled in a connection pool. Like this is one pool and this is second pool and this is third pool. All will be all the connection will be grouped together here, kind of pooling mechanism. And then from this pool, the connectivity connection to the database is established. The clients or users or application gets a physical connection to the connection pool, and connection pool creates a physical connection to the database. So it is like client to the database direct physical connection, but inside the connection pool it is a logical mechanism, logical method. If you just assume clients are all grouped together as a connection pool, and then from connection pool the database connection will be established. So that the FAN will be aware that which group to notify when the node goes down. If I go to next slide, it will be more clear. See here, this is one connection pool, and this connection pool, if I go back, this connection pool is connected to my database, and if this node goes down, these connection pool members are supposed like connected to this node one, and the moment node goes down, the FAN will be triggered, the event will be triggered, and then these pool members are automatically connected to any other connection pool, and then from this connection pool any one of the surviving node will be assigned to this connection pool. So the basic concept of load balancing I already explained, like I'm going to explain one more time here. The connection time load balancing and runtime load balancing. So I said connection time load balancing because my scan is, I said, 3 IPs is going to span 100, 200, 300, and then whenever the client try to connect, it will first try to connect 100, and then it will try to connect 200, and then it will try to connect 300. All this connection will be in a round robin, 100, 200, 300, and again 100, 200, 300. Like that load will be distributed among all these three. For example, 10 connection comes, it will not directly going to connect to 100, and 20 connection comes, it will not going to connect to 200. It will be like round robin, one at a time it is assigned to all the client connections. That is how connection time load balance is achieved. And once the client connection is established to the scan, and from the scan is smart enough to decide which node is the least connection, and then it is going to, for example, node 1, 2, 3, one has least connection, only one connection, from the scan it is going to assign it to the node 1. And node 2 and 3 having 10 connection or 10 and 20 connection, and second connection comes and scan is smart enough to again assign it to node 1 because node 1 is become 3 connection now, and third connection comes and this scan is smart enough to assign again connection back to node 1 because it has only 3 connection, now it become 4 connection. The scan is smart enough to find out which node having a least connection or least load, and then it will assign it. So that is a runtime load balancing. See, I already said connection time load balancing. Here I already mentioned in the parameter you are going to mention load_balanced equal to on. So load_balanced equal to on, failure equal to on. So that will be achieved in this connection time load balancing. So this is at the client side where the TNS is going to play a major role for this load balancing. And at the server side, the load balance is going to happen with the help of PMON. PMON is dynamic register all the server information, like all the server load, how many connections are there at my server. For example, PMON will be running on all three nodes, and PMON will collect all the stats from this node, how many connections are there, what is the load, with the help of OS stats, it will send it to the listener. And then listener, the moment receives the connection from the scan, it will try to connect to which is a least loaded connection. So like with the help of PMON register dynamically server stats to the scan, and then scan will gives connection to the least node at server. So what are the information the PMON is going to register at the listener side? 1 minute OS, node average for all 30 seconds, and number of connection on each instance, and number of connection to each dispatcher. So all this information is going to pass it to the listener, and then scan is going to decide which node having a least connection, and then with least noded connection, it will hand over the new incoming connection. Then this is the method how client side, server side, the load balancing is going to happen. It's going to be achieved. So the fan, how it is going to play a major role here, connection time load balancing and runtime load balancing. If you see here, like I have instance 1, 2, 3, instance 1 is of 30% connection, and instance 2, okay, instance 2 is of 10% connection, and instance 3 is of 60% connection. But even though connections are high, PMON will get the stats of the instances, what is the load, and for example, this single connection itself should be having multiple threads, or it will be doing multiple jobs. So that is why the fan not only consider the connection, it will also consider the what is the load on the nodes. All this node information can be provided by the PMON. If I go back to my previous slide, see, this is PMON, right? PMON is responsible for getting the number of each connections, number of connections on each node, and number of connection to each dispatcher, and 1 minute OS load average. So based upon the load average, you can say that even though number of connections are high here, 60% connection, but it is idle. This server is 60% connection, but nothing is doing here, all are idle. And it is only having 10 connection, but very high transactions they are doing, it very busy. And this instance 1 having 30% connection, but it's a little busy, they are doing only few transactions. So whenever new connection comes, obviously it will go to instance 3. Irrespective of these connections, the load is very less here because all the connections are idle. So the incoming connection, this mark, it will go to this connection pool, and this connection pool will connect to this instance 3. This connection pool is achieved by using fan. So this using this connection time load balancing and real time load balancing can be achieved using fan. This fan, how this fan is going to get the details using the PMON, all the stats will be registered with your listener, and then the event will be triggered. Fan is like it is going to trigger kind of events or messages when the node goes down or when the server load is high. All these events will be triggered, and it will be distributed across all the cluster nodes, all the cluster services, so that all the cluster services and all applications should be aware that what is my cluster status, so that the next incoming connection is going to send it to what is the least noded connections. That can be achieved using this fan. And you can you can go back to Oracle Mass document for this introduction to automatic workload management for more information about this fan and how the load balancing will be handled. Okay, with this TFA and fan and the client connection and then load balancing and high availability, so I hope today's session I'm going to conclude. As usual, I used to ask a question. The today's question is, what is TFA and fan, and what are their use cases? Please do comment your answer in my YouTube channel. I'm going to give a brief explanation on these questions in my next session. Thank you.